try it again. Let's test your memory. Do you remember who I am? I am worried that you are holding back. Try speaking with some emotion. Doctor, yes. And note this down. Do you know why you're here? You're having trouble with your memory. We're trying to help you. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath. And let the walls fall away. Try to visualize the last thing you can remember before you came here. So, did you remember anything? Describe it to me. Interesting. Doctor, we seem to be making some progress. Is there anything else? Any small details? Nothing is too insignificant. What year is it now? Correct. Very good. I'm going to try this again. So, please, relax, take a deep breath, think about that moment, and concentrate. No matter how much it may scare or upset you, it's important you face the hard truth. What can you recall? Perhaps we've been pushing you too hard. I know this hasn't been easy, but I'd really like to try once more. Do you think you have it in you? Concentrate. Let the memory come in. So far, it appears to be completely successful. Now, what can you tell me? You've had enough excitement for now. Perhaps we did push the limits today. Wouldn't want to chew off more than we can bite. One final thing, and it's the key to the success of this treatment. You do understand I want what's best for you. Good. You should know that we have made remarkable progress today. You must learn to walk before you can crawl. time now to rest and heal. Let the memories come home to roost. This'll help. And I'll have an orderly take you to your room. Let's talk outside.
Yet. You don't remember your good old buddy Abe? Guess we still got that amnesia. Time to put you back on the shelf. That old brag will take his toys apart just to see if he can put them back together again.
Hope he's not losing his touch.
Hi. Hello, Suzanne. Always good to see your face. Well, shoot. Guess I ain't fit to shine her shoes. You think a girl like that would ever give me the time of day? Look who's talking, big guy. At least I ain't wearing prophylactic pajamas. Let me just call us a cab. Hello, you get out much? We're in the world-famous Blackwood Sanatorium and Hotel. Well, not so much the hotel part, but here we are. The presidential... Wouldn't want to be late for your spa treatment. Yeesh. You think Braggett's spring for an upgrade? For the staff's sake, at least. Whole place going to pieces. Giving you the good stuff. Three sheets to something, all right. Duty calls. Smart cookie over there.
Okay, that's enough fun.
Hey now, you're back. Just a little blackout, no big deal. All just part of the treatment. Almost back to your private little oasis.
You're okay. Look at me. Everything is going to be okay.
Let's get you ready for that. All right, lights out.
Rise and shine. Greet the new day. Come on. Wakey, wakey. Up, up, up. Let's see what you got. Upsy-daisy. Have a look around. Why don't you take in the view? I'm gonna need you to focus again. What'd I tell ya? I had odds on you. Gonna make me a rich man. White wall tires and a 3-martini lunch. Now, walk. Come to Papa. There we go. Keep coming. Wow. Almost ready for the triathlon. Now, let's try going back to the bet. Good. Real good. Now just stroll around a bit. Stretch those legs. Yeah, the blood flow. I want you to just take your time. Move at your own pace. Take all day if you need to. No sweat off my back. You know, on a clear day, you can see those shiny peaks on those mountains winking back at you. Mind if I stick around while you get your sea legs, matey? What's wrong? You okay? Is that so? Well, Bragg told me to let him know if you started filling in the blanks.
Hey, come quick.
Yeesh, guy can't get a break around here. Did you find a piece of paper with my, notes scribbled on it? Did you read my notes? You really shouldn't have. I guess you were just killing time, but curiosity killed the cat. Let's get you ready for bed. Lights out soon. All right, lights out.
Napoleon Donner.
bud. Just follow me. Come along.
Rise and shine. Good morning to you. You should know we are very encouraged.
You're
on the road to a complete recovery.
You can't treat me like this! Someone get me out of here!
Of course, there are always going to be patients that are beyond our help. But I know that you only want to get better. Maybe you should meet your new roommate. Is almost upon us. It's a leap year. We'll have a whole extra day. Who knows how we'll spend it? They always said you can do things on a leap day you can't on any other. Like a woman proposing to a man. Is that crazy?
We're acting like you'd actually seen something unusual out there. All I see is snow or trees. Or were you just daydreaming? Well, that's a fine way to pass the time around here. Commune with your thoughts. What brings you to this fine establishment? That's what they got me in here for, too. Crazy thing is, I don't have amnesia. Everything is clear as a bell. Doesn't stop them from messing with my noggin. So, these treatments, they ever get any easier? Don't know how much I can take. Name's Gordon. You? Damn. I can't get a break. I'm gonna grab some shut-eye. Talk later. Hey, buddy. You all right? You were shaking the sheets a little last night. Look, about before, I don't want you to get the wrong idea about me. I don't know what they're doing to me, but it's just, I haven't been myself. I think it's...
Gentlemen.
Did I make parole?
You're not a prisoner. Bragg's looking into your case personally. For now, I get comfortable.
God damn it, Victoria. What do you make of her? You think she's on the level? What you got against her, buddy?
I see someone was hungry. Very, very good.
Fucking tell me what to do. Good thing they saved all the cigarette butts and bottle caps for this gruel. Ugh, how can anyone eat this? I don't know how many more of these I can take. So give it up. You want out of here. Screw this voluntary nonsense, right? That landed you in here. You don't give off that rubber room vibe, you know? Who were you on the outside? Yeah. In this place, the doctor's the ones with the screws loose. You can take that to the bank. Anyway, you really don't remember anything else? Don't give up. You're a fighter, I can tell. You'll get it all back. Now, I think I need to put all my energy into shoving this toxic waste down my throat. When the hell am I getting out of here?
I'm sorry, I don't...
You told me you would have an answer.
Brad wants you here. Just a little bit longer.
You tell Brad that I'm done. I voluntarily choose to leave.
Fine, I... Okay. I'll let him know.
Can't trust anyone in this damn snake pit. Right? You don't trust a word they say either, do you? Ship of fools.
Oh, sorry. I'll be right back.
Chicken cookie. Bragg said the treatment would be kicking in. Slow and steady wins the race.
Hey, Mr. Sandman, come over here. Another patient on the loose. Cue the three-ring circus. Not like it doesn't happen once a week around here. They'll have them doped and drooling in no time. Look, you and I, we're not like the rest of the folks in here. You get that, right? Speak for yourself. I guess I take it back. We have trouble with our memories. It'd be a lot worse from what I've seen around here. They should just take... In God's name, what's that? Yeah, this is serious. I need a minute. Let me just think about this.
right this way.
Finally, you sleep like the dead. It's been 2 days since they've come. Nothing. For 2 days. They'll be back for me soon. They will be, right? No. No, I'm sure they'll be back. Whatever's happened, they can handle it. There's a backup plan for everything. Believe me. Jesus. You look like you're right on the edge. Well, I don't know about you, but I'm famished. I'm sure there's still some food around here. Any little scrap will do.
Why are you doing this to me?
Come here. I think I got something. Ah, look at this. So got it, Gordo. You have no idea how hungry I am. Who knew that under the right circumstances, stale bread could taste like caviar? And don't you worry, Bragg will have this whole mess sorted before you know it. I suggest you rest up, save your energy. He'll be around for us soon. Yes? What is it? They'll be here soon. You just gotta be patient. Get it? Be patient. You okay? Memories? Really? Like what? Huh. Well, ain't that something? Why would a doctor be locked in a cell? That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. I'm bushed. Why don't we both get some rest? Sweet dreams. I mean that.
Hey! Come here, goddammit! You sniveling sons of bitches, help! You can't just leave me in here. You can't do this to me. I'm not supposed to be here, goddammit. I can't believe this is happening. Oh, goddamn week they just leave me in here. This is Bragg all over. That two-faced son of a whore.
He thinks he can get rid of me, like trash. Well, buckle up, Bragg. I've almost got a brick free with this spoon. It's pretty good, right? Right. Yeah. It is a great idea. Ah, come on! Look what you did! That was our only chance! Calm? You kidding? What the hell is wrong with you? Are you trying to get us killed?
Treatment is working.
Sure of it.
Tremendous progress. Only a coward would take the path of the prey.
I'm worthy.
No, don't come in here. It's me.
No, not me. I'm worthless. Oh, it's just you. Look, I'm sorry about hitting you. Things are, they're not right. It's no excuse, but I just want you to understand I didn't mean to hurt you. No, please. I don't deserve to be forgiven. Worst part is, I barely made a scratch. I'd need 100 spoons to get that brick out. It's been a week, you know? You ever gone that long before? Not me. I've always heard about starvation was bad, but I don't know how much longer a body can hold on. Do you? It's time to accept our fate. Who has the strength to fight it? I lay awake. I can't stop thinking about one little cave-in and 30 men. Down in that mine for weeks. How's that even possible? Only 12 made it out of the frying pan. And then leave it to Bragg to hear opportunity knock and know how to cover his ass. You never really have to think about what you might be capable of. Down in the mine. Stuck in a cell? What's the difference? We're all alone. And hungry. In the end. It's a good question. And what's the point of hiding it now? I mean, really? Who are you gonna tell? I'm not really a... What the hell was that?
Hey! Hey! Help! We're in here! Help us!
Oh, dear Lord in heaven, it really happened. It's one of the miners, isn't it? Oh, damn it, Bragg! It's time to eat. I saved one just for you. Beggars can't be choosers. You haven't eaten in days. Doctor's orders. All right. Well, thank you, pal. Good God, it's delicious. so calm outside. It's almost peaceful. I used to think I'd spend the rest of my life on this beautiful mountain. I just thought I had a lot more of it left.
Look at me. I shouldn't even be here. And yet, here I am, eating cockroaches to survive. You must think I'm disgusting. There's no one out there, is there? We're the last two people on Earth. And we'll die in here alone.
Mr. Bragg will start your treatment tomorrow.
We need to talk. I hope you can understand that none of this was supposed to happen. I didn't want it to happen, but it is my fault. And if you can, please, forgive me. You believe me, right? Yes. Well, you're right not to, of course. I've been here a long time. I've seen a lot of patients come and go. All I ever wanted to do was help them. But this is what it comes to. This. And if I get out of here, it's a new start. Clean slate. People can change, right? I hope so. You should get some rest. This doesn't feel right.
Where the hell have you been? I didn't know where I was. I couldn't figure out where I... Go! What are you doing? Are you out of your minds?
Easy, dog. Easy. could use a little help here. Let's just get out of here.
Check it out over here. Got him. In here.
We were down there for weeks, starving. Now he's put us in these cages. You gotta help me, Doc!
February 26th, and we're
this is for your own good. Better safe than sorry.
Please, I gotta eat.
Maybe we should give him something to chew on.
It's out of the question. It would undermine the veracity of the tests.
Who are you? All right. I just needed to know you weren't, one of those things. Didn't want to freak you out, but I've been keeping my eye on you. Shit! That's one of them. It's close by. Anyone back the way you came? I don't know what's going on. But you better come with me. This way. Better safe than sorry. Lucky I found you. The whole damn place was starting to feel like a ghost town. I think we're okay. For the time being, anyway. I'm David, I work here. How long have you been in here? Yeah, some patients can't even remember what day it is. I get it. Why are you alone here anyhow? Everybody already left. You pissed someone off? This whole place has got the stench of something rotten. Since they brought those miners here, they were supposed to get better. Jesus. Better. Not exactly what I'd call it. No, it wasn't the staff. They did everything they could for the men. But something was very wrong. The miners, they turned feral, vicious, rabid, like nothing you've ever seen. The staff, they didn't have a chance. I think maybe you know what I'm talking about, don't you? There were other survivors. They're not far.
But just so you know, I got my eye on you. Stay near me, will you? We're almost to Bragg's office. Everybody else is holed up with Ted in the chapel. I'd be there too, but you know Bragg. It's always something with him. He had to go back, and Suzanne and I are his escorts. They should be waiting for me in his office. I came out here to scope it out. Watch your step. Take it nice and slow. I haven't seen any of the miners since the incident. I can still hear them, though. Mostly outside. I mean, I think it's them. Ugh, gives me the chills every time. His office is right down the hall. Bragg was not exactly pleased someone called in the cops. I guess he's worried they'll catch a whiff of something they ain't supposed to. Hearing about it's one thing. Seeing it, she was a good lady. Didn't deserve that. I hope when the police show up, they plug every last fucking miner they see. Here we are, head honcho himself. Hey, it's David. Can I come in?
Enter.
Bragg, Suzanne, got another live one.
I'm glad you made it out in one piece.
As am I. We thought you'd, well, suffered the same fate as the others. About your roommate? Yes, Gordon is a dear friend and colleague, one of our staff doctors. Not a patient. I'm sorry, but the deception was necessary. I needed to observe your progress as closely as possible. It was all in an effort to ensure your complete recovery. I know this is difficult, but can you tell me if any more memories have resurfaced? Rest assured, your memory will return in time. Though none of this really matters anymore. I should never have come back. Sorry, I thought I could right the ship. But you can't steer a ship in a squall.
Mr. Bragg, you've been down before. You'll pull us all through, I know you will.
Oh, Suzanne, my dear. I admire your optimism, but it's misplaced in me. This is, it's just too big to keep quiet. I'm finished.
No, Mr. Bragg, please, let's just go to the chaff bowl. The storm's lit up, the police are on their way.
The chapel.
Thank you.
Go now. I'm staying here.
We can't leave you behind. It's not safe. Please. You know we all have to go. Everyone, Bragg included.
Stop! Enough! This place belongs to me. I belong to it. Now get the hell out of here.
Mr. Bragg.
Suzanne, stop. Come on. He's made up his mind.
No. No!
We gotta go now while we still can.
Gordon. Be careful with your charge. The right information at the wrong time can turn apples to sand.
I don't know what the hell that's supposed to mean. Don't forget who's really responsible for all this.
I believe I've made myself perfectly clear. Get the hell out of here and leave me alone. Can't you just... All right, fine, all right. It's so important to you. Go on ahead and I'll catch up. I'll be right behind you. Just get out of here. There's only one thing in the world that will command my attention now. And it's inside this bottle.
understand. Why wouldn't Bragg want to come with us?
He built this place. Would you be able to leave that behind? Oh, Jesus, look at that.
Oh, God, it's awful.
Christ, what happened here?
What do we do to deserve this?
Let me go. Just let me go home. I just want to see my family again.
What's up with you? You're as white as a sheet.
Wait, we don't know what's out there.
There was nothing out there before.
Let's just go one at a time. You remember what Ted said?
One of those things shows up, don't move a fucking muscle.
I'll go first.
Okay, I'm next. When I get to the other side, I'll give the signal.
You next, or am I? Okay, I'll follow.
Nonsense.
All right. Easy. Take it easy.
You all have no idea how lucky you are to be alive.
We didn't exactly have much of a choice.
No. Rack doesn't offer much in the way of choices, does he? What happened to the old fool?
He wouldn't listen to reason. Guess he wanted to go out on his own terms.
Yes. Well, if Bragg had made up his mind, there's nothing on heaven or earth that would have changed it. Father Ted Mosley, I'm glad to meet another survivor.
Father, the only reason we're alive right now is because you told us not to move. At first I couldn't believe it, but...
I saw it all from here. I'm glad you made it back here. Not everyone has been so lucky today. The mythology I've been telling you about, the story of these things, I never knew how true it all was. This is not a disease. This is not a virus. This is a curse. There are more survivors holed up in the administration offices. They still think it's an infection. They have no idea what they're up against. They need our help. I've been so worried about each and every one of you. I warned Bragg something like this could happen. I warned him there was something here on the mountain. An evil spirit, powerful. But he wouldn't listen.
It's like what happened to the miners. What they did to each other to survive.
When I was a missionary interacting with the native people, I'd hear these stories told with great conviction. But of course, back then I only trusted in my own faith, so I dismissed them as mere superstition. Unsubstantiated campfire tales. They spoke of monsters that got inside of you. Monsters that fed on human flesh, insatiable, hungry, rapacious. They said the only way to elude the creatures was to remain perfectly still. But beyond that, there was no way to fend them off. They called them Wendigo. I never truly believed they were real, until now. I'd advise everyone to get a little shut-eye while we can. Excuse me.
Suzanne, just hold tight. They're coming to get us out of this.
How are we gonna get out of this? You think the police are really on their way?
Hey, hey, hey. Don't be scared. They'll be here soon.
Sooner the better.
It's okay. It's gonna be fine. Listen, you should get some shut-eye before the cops show up.
I need some time to myself. Maybe get some rest before the police arrive.
I think I'd prefer to be alone, not feeling myself. I need to rest. I'd advise you to do the same.
with fire, Brad. There's something bigger than the two of us at work in this place, and we've got to be careful.
Stuff and nonsense. What you're saying is ludicrous.
Hold your fire! Hold your fire! I said stop shooting! Calm down, ma'am. Please. Stop. God damn it. Shooting into a crowd? Have you all lost your mind?
Would you please come and help me?
Go! Go! Keep moving! Don't stop!
I can't keep running.
You can do it, Suzanne. Come on!
Stop! Wait.
Great. Now what the hell do we do?
They saw us head this way. Gotta be right under tail.
David, help me with the door.
Yeah. Come on!
Hey, how are you feeling? Service tunnel connects to the hotel. You should rest up for now. You nearly caught a bullet with your skull. Took a tumble and hit your head pretty hard. You'll be all right.
Folks, we gotta keep moving. No time.
Not everyone can keep up with you, Gordon.
Why would they just open fire like that?
The police saw the miner, what he'd become, and they reacted.
Reacted? People are dead, man. That's a pretty big fucking reaction.
I think we all need to calm down, think this through.
What is that? Are you hearing that?
It was a misunderstanding. That's all it was. We just need to explain it to them. We should go back.
police know we saw what they did. That makes us witnesses. We need to get out of here. This tunnel will take us to the hotel, and from there, off the mountain. Can they walk?
Keep your eyes on my finger. Good. Response seems normal.
Oh, shut up! I'm trying to think! Do you really not hear all these voices?
Gordon, there are no voices.
You're lying to me! Of course there are! They won't stop!
You need to take it easy.
Get off of me!
No, Doc! What the hell's your problem?
We can't stay here any longer. Can you stand?
You'll be fine. One step at a time.
You can do it. Let's go.
You might want to leave this here. Don't want to blow your cover. Good luck. Where you're going to need all your money.
Sounds like they're giving up on that door. But won't be long before they find another way in. We should go.
How are you holding up?
The miners and the police? If this is all a terrible dream, I just want to wake up. Or at least get off this mountain.
We should be safe in the hotel. Victor keeps most of the place in lockdown for winter.
I doubt Victor's even alive.
Victor knows this place like the back of his hand. If anyone could make it, it's him.
Victor, is that you? Jesus, fuck!
All right. Show's over. Let's move on. Victor manages to cram the entire hotel in here for the winter. Look how organized. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Sets a fine example.
Please, Ted, we have to stay focused.
Looks to me like Victor's been here recently.
I'm telling you, this sort of press really gets under Bragg's skin. I'd advise you to be careful.
far to the elevator?
We're now in the basement of the Blackwood Pines. The elevator up ahead will take us there.
You hear that? What was it?
I don't know.
Ted, I'm sorry I pushed you. I don't know what came over me.
We've got to stick together.
You heard them, right? The voices?
Dr. Bennett, there are no voices. I'm worried you might be malnourished. It could be affecting your perception.
Nonsense. I'm perfectly fine. You don't seem yourself, Dr. Bennett. I'm going to keep an eye on you. Come on, don't fall behind. Elevator's this way.
That's everything.
That's everything.
Well now.
Well now.
Doctor. I can only hope you have better luck than the last guy.
It's not far.
Blend in. Try it for size.
Just make your way to the elevator. Once everyone's in, we can go.
Shit! We're all gonna get slaughtered! There's no way out!
We just have to get to the second floor! We're almost there! We're gonna make it!
Looks like it got hit by one of the bullets. Damn it. What now?
God damn this shit!
No. Oh no, it's the police again.
Those fuckers are supposed to be on our side.
Everyone just calm down. There's no point in panicking. We have to get out of here now.
Found it.
Got to get out of here.
Shots!
Victor, it's the police. We need the cable car. If we don't leave, they will execute every single one of us they can find.
The police? There has to be some mistake.
Can you get the door open from your side?
Think so, yeah.
My God! What the fuck was that?
Are you okay?
Yeah. Still breathing.
Follow me. I'm sorry. I cannot allow you to leave this mountain.
No. No. I suppose not, huh? Never should have listened to Bragg. We knew we were kicking the hornet's nest. Go. I'll operate the cable car. You should get as far away from me as you can.
Into the car.
Any longer!
What a story. What a goddamn story you got.
Was it worth it?
What now? Is it over?
So many lies.
Look at me. I'm a reasonable man. So let's get down to business. You say you saw all sorts of bad stuff up on Blackwood Mountain. But I say you broke into a reputable institution under false pretenses. Who do you think people are going to believe? Oh, sure, you'll be free to go soon enough. I just need assurance you're not going to go and do something, self-destructive, like publish a cockamamie story about what you think went down up there. Yeah, that's right. I know all about you. Your editors have been worried sick. As much as I'd like to see you just, disappear, this puts me in a bit of a squeeze. And I don't like to be squeezed. Now, what story are we going to tell our editor, See? Reasonable. Just like me. Now, let's get you home, huh? Just remember, I'll be watching.
I see it now. It's so simple, it's so easy.